Hello everyone. Now in this lecture we know about the next normalization form. That one is third normal form. We already understood the 1NF, 2NF. 1NF, that one is the particular attribute, it's not contains a multi value. Then in a 2NF, that one is 2NF contains the rule about it should be in a 1NF. And second, that one is not a partially dependent non-prime attribute, it's not partially dependent on a primary key, right? If it is a partially dependent, then that one is not in a 2NF. It's fully dependent, then we can say that it's a 1NF, 2NF, right? Then the rule for 3NF is a third normal form. Is an upgrade to a second normal form. Then that one is when a table is in a second normal form and has a no transitive dependency, then it is in a third normal form. Means a 2NF, it should the given table in a 2NF. If we go with the condition of 2NF, it should be in a 1NF and with a no partially dependency. Then it's a 2NF, and the third in a third normal form, it should be in a 2NF with a no transitive dependency. Now we need to know about the what exact the no transitive dependency. Then our last tutorial we learn about the second normal form. Then we need to take this same example as a student table, subject table and score table. Now student table, subject table and the score table. Now score table contains a student ID, subject ID and the marks. Now in a score table we need to store the some more information, which is the exam name and the total marks. Now we will update the score table with the exam name and total marks. Consider exam name as an online exam in same exam, right? Subject ID, it may be the second year subject. If second year have the online exam, then B as a subject have the in same exam, right? It's a total mark for online, it's a total marks is a 50, and the particular marks obtained of the particular student in a particular subject. Now requirement for the third normal form, it's simply the for table to be in a third normal, it should be in a 2NF. If we go with the rule for 2NF, that table should be in a 1NF, and it's not no partially dependent partially dependency in a particular table, then we can say that is in a 2NF, right? Now the it should not have a transitive dependency. Then we need to know about what exact the transitive dependency means. What now exam name and total marks added to our score table, we add the two more column under the score table, that is exam name and total marks. Exam name and total marks, it saves more data. Now primary key for our score table is a composite key, that is a subject student ID and subject ID. Student ID and subject ID, which means it made up of two attribute, its column student ID and subject ID. Our new column exam name depend on both student and subject. If we go with the exam name, definitely exam name is depend on a student ID and the subject ID also, because of online exam only have for the second year subject and the second year student, right? That's why exam name is totally depend on the primary keys, it's not again with the partially. Marks is also totally depend on this, which subject marks and which student marks, means marks also depend on both IDs, both primary keys. Same thing exam name is also. Now the exam name and total marks are our new column exam name depend on both student and a subject. For example, that one is I already explained you how exact exam name is depend on both. It's the same with the example. What about the our second new column, that is total marks, is it depend on the score table primary key? Total marks is depend on the student ID and the subject ID. Total marks about what? Total marks about the subject ID? No. Total marks about what? Student ID? No. That one is not depend on this two primary key, but it's depend on the exam name. Because of online exam, if we mention that online exam, then its total marks is a 50 for the online exam. If we take a exam name as a INSEM, by default its total marks for INSEM exam is a 30. That's why the total marks is depend on exam name. It's not depend on a subject ID and subject student ID. Then this one is simply the concept related to the now that one is what exact the transitive dependency. Its exam name or the total marks is not depend on these two primary key or composite key, but exam name is depend on these two. Means, or we can say that the total marks is only depend on exam name. Now the the column total marks depend on exam name as with the exam type or total score changes, right? If we say that the exam is INSEM, then total marks is again change. If we say that the exam is online, then total marks is change. Means total marks is depend on exam name. Now, but exam name is just another column in the score table. It is not a primary key or even a part of a primary key. And total marks is depend on. If we check exam name is not a part of a primary key or not a primary key, right? And the total marks is depend on that. Then what exact the situation comes? Exam name is just another column in the score table. It's not a primary key or even a part of a primary key, and total marks is depend on it. This is a transitive dependency. When non-prime attribute depend on other non-prime attributes rather than depending on the primary key, rather than depend on a primary key or a primary attribute, that attribute that type of dependency called as a transitive dependency. Now we need to know about what exact the non-prime attribute. What exact the non-prime attribute? The attribute that form a candidate key or a relation, attribute of a candidate key are called the prime attributes. Means we can say that the student ID, student subject ID or the score ID, we can say that it's a prime attributes because it's a part of a primary key, right? Marks is not a prime attribute. Exam name is not a prime attribute. Total marks is not a prime attribute. These three are non-prime attributes and these three are the prime attributes, we can say that, right? Now why the total marks is the table contained a transitive dependency? Because of marks is depend on these two, exam name is depend on these two, but the total marks is not depend on the prime attributes, it's depend on non-prime attributes. Exam name is a non-prime, but exam name as a non-prime, which means depend on a prime attributes here, but the total marks is a non-prime, which is not depend on a prime attributes, it is depend on a non-prime attributes. That's why we can say that it's run with the transitive dependency. It's a transition. It's a non-prime attributes, total marks is a non-prime and it's depend on a non-prime again. It should be depend on the prime attributes. That's why it's a transitive dependency. Non-prime attributes depend on the non-prime attributes. Then this is simply the non-prime attributes and dependency or the transitive dependency. Means when we say that the table contains a transitive dependency, when the one non-prime attribute depend on another non-prime attributes, then we can say that table contains a transitive dependency. Now, how to remove the transitive dependency? Now the solution is we just do a marks and exam ID. We just do a create a new table as a new exam table. It contains a exam ID, exam name, and total marks of exam. And we just to add the exam ID under the score table. Now, if we go with the verifies the transitive dependency, marks is non-prime, which means depend on this primary keys. Then that is not depend on again a non-prime attribute. Exam ID is again the depend on the student ID and subject ID, right? That is also is not a non-prime attribute, but it's depend on a primary keys, right? Exam ID of which subject, right? Exam ID for the which subject? It's again related to these two. Means it's not run with the transitive dependency. If we check this table, it's again exam ID, exam name, it's again depend on exam ID. Total marks is again depend on the exam ID. That's why it's not run with any transitive dependency, right? Total marks is depend on exam ID, right? 200 exam, or we can say that 30 marks, then definitely exam name is in same, and in same exam have a particular exam ID. If the end same exam have 70 marks, then exam name is end same exam, and end same exam have a unique exam ID. Means total marks is again depend on exam ID. Exam name is again depend on exam ID. That's why both table does not contain any transitive dependency. Transitive dependency means what? Non-prime attributes depend on a non-prime. Then both table does not contain a transitive dependency. Does not contain a multi-value attribute. Means it's in a 1NF. Then again, if we check it as a 2NF, the 2NF is a partially dependency. Is there any partially dependency? No. Total marks is totally dependent on exam ID, is a primary key. Exam name is totally dependent on exam ID, is a primary key. Exam ID is totally dependent on both student ID and subject ID, same as a marks. That's why it's not again the break the 2NF rule. It's a partially, is no partially dependency. It's a fully partial, it's a fully dependent on a primary keys. That's why both table with a 1NF also, with a 2NF also, and with a 3NF also, because of it's not, does not contain the transitive dependency also. Not a 2NF a rule or not a 1NF. Means particular table not breaks the 1NF rule, 2NF rule, and 3NF rules. That's why it's a 3NF form. It's simply the way the convert the existing table into the 3NF. Advantage of removing a transitive dependency, amount of data duplication is reduced. Data integrity achieved. Means if we run with the transitive dependency, it run with the redundant of data and the integrity problem. Inconsistency in the data, right? That is simply the 3NF. Means under the 3NF, we need to know about the what exact the concept of transitive dependency, right? That is simply the 3NF. Thank you.